Warning, the following video may contain adult language and themes. Viewer discretion is strongly advised. If you have a problem with this, please stop playing this video now. Okay, so I just got done watching another horror movie. This one was called, I believe, The Shrine. It's called The Shrine, and it was released in 2010. And the only recognizable name that was in the movie, that I recognized at least, was Aaron Ashmore, and I believe he's one of the Ashmore twins. If you don't know, I think the other one's Sean Ashmore, and I think he's most famous for starring in the X-Men franchise. At least that's what I know him from. I get them mixed up, though. I don't know which one he is. But yeah, he's, in my opinion, the most recognizable name, and in my opinion, he elevated this movie with his class. You know, he added a little bit of class. If it weren't for him, I would say this is a direct-to-DVD cast. I didn't recognize anybody else, but they look like D-list actors and actresses. Okay, first, let me give you my spoiler-free review without going into any detail. I would summarize this film as, it's only 80 minutes long, approximately. I would say the first half of this movie is really average. It's so boring, and it's so crap. It was just boring. It wasn't even bad in a good way. You know, it's just so boring, really bad acting, really poor cinematography, just moved at a glacial pace. But at around the halfway mark, it sort of picked up and was an okay horror movie. It was an okay horror movie. So that's my review. Out of 10, I'd probably give it a 5.8. Maybe a 5.9, but even then, that's being generous. One thing that could have saved this movie is a really good, you know, final act or a final twist to the movie, and it didn't pull it off well enough. Okay, I'm gonna get into spoilers now. Basically, this is just the synopsis. Basically, there's this girl who's a reporter, and her boyfriend, who is the Ashmore guy. Basically, we get introduced to them, and she's a reporter, and she's looking for a juicy story. And she's heard about this American tourist who went over to Poland and has disappeared, and so she's gonna go investigate it. She's a struggling reporter, so of course she doesn't tell her boss where she's going, because her boss thinks she's going to do some other story, some other boring story. So she takes her boyfriend, Sean Ashmore, and her, like, intern, young intern, over to this Polish village to investigate, to try to find out what happened to this kid. And so they go there, and it's very hostile-ish. You know, if you've seen Hostel, you know, the people in this village are very, you know, cold, and they speak with a very bad Polish accent. It's very bad. I don't know if these were actually Polish people, but the accents sucked. I didn't believe it for one second. And when they go over there, this movie reminded me a lot of Hostel, The Wicker Man, and The Exorcist. And once you see the movie, you'll see why. And they go over there, and it's such an average horror movie. I'm gonna get more into spoilers. We're getting to spoilers now, but I don't give a fuck, because I would not recommend this movie. Basically, they get to this village, and, you know, they see, you know, they get welcomed, they get this very cold welcome, you know, from the villagers. They, like, won't talk to them. It's very Wicker Man-ish, you know. It's this very isolated village of these people who kind of keep to themselves, and there even is this, like, very, you know, plain, creepy-looking little girl who is playing in the fields, and they go up to her, and she's like, "You're not supposed to be here. Go away," you know? And then there's this really cold, like, village person guy who's like, "You must leave now, English. Go back to England, you know? Get out of here," you know? And so the woman reporter is not gonna take no for an answer. She's like, "I know something's going on here. We have to, you know, go back and find out what's going on." So basically, they go back, and they see this big billowing cloud, you know, and they're like, that's very suspicious, you know. I read in this guy who disappeared, his journal, he talks about the billowing cloud, and so she goes to investigate, and what ends up happening is, just the two girls go into the intern and his girlfriend, Sean Ashmore's girlfriend, go into the cloud to look for, you know, the missing person, and they stumble upon this statue that this movie tries to play up as creepy, but it just looks like something out of, it looks like an orc out of, like, The Lord of the Rings or Warcraft. It doesn't look threatening at all. You know, they try to play it off as threatening, but it's just not. And this is about the point of the movie where I was getting really fed up because nothing was happening. The movie, like, was moving at a glacial pace. It just wasn't scary. It was trying to play it off as creepy. The music sucked, so it didn't get you in the mood. It was just this very one-note music. You'll know when you listen to it if you dare to watch this fucking bad, terrible movie. And, So only the two girls go into the fog. They come out and they're all spooked because they saw this weird statue that sort of creeped them out, like it bled and everything, and it looked at them. And so, basically, the spoilers is that the village people, you know, of the Polish village, they come after them, they chase them, because a little side note is that I did not have subtitles for when the Polish people were speaking. So, I highly doubt that that detracted from the movie for me, though, because unless there was some hidden gem, you know, in the translation, I highly doubt that it would have made a difference. But basically, the Polish villagers chase them, Sean Ashmore and his girlfriend and the intern, and they drag them off into this dungeon, and they, like, sacrifice the girl intern in a very brutal way. That actually was a positive of the film, because it was very shocking. I mean, if you can't do anything else in your film, at least be, in your horror film, at least be shocking. The way they sacrifice the girl is pretty shocking. And Sean Ashmore, you know, escapes and rescues his girlfriend from the villagers. And the twist is, here's the twist. The villagers aren't actually the bad guys. Basically, what happened was, the girls, like, when you see the statue, you get possessed, and you become like this demon. And so, you know, it basically rips off of Exorcist, and when his girlfriend turns into a demon, it looks straight out of Exorcist, you know? And the sad thing is that I didn't even think Exorcist was that scary to begin with. So, when you're ripping off Exorcist, it's even worse. So, Sean Ashmore, ends up helping the villagers sacrifice his girlfriend to expel the demon. And that's basically it. Sean Ashmore gets to go home, and that's it. You know, this movie, the payoff just wasn't worth it. It rips off movies that are much better. Exorcist, Hostel, The Wicker Man. The Beast, not the Beast! How to get burned! Not my eyes! The Beast! It rips off, like, better movies, you know. At least The Wicker Man was good on a so-bad-it's-good level. You know, the one with Nicolas Cage, at least. I actually didn't like the original Wicker Man. I didn't think it was that good. But anyway, But supposedly it's a classic. But anyway, so that's my opinion on the film. I'd give it a 5.8 to 5.9. Ugh, probably a 5.8. It just wasn't worth the payoff. The payoff just wasn't worth it. The 40 minutes before it actually gets to the okay part is just unbearable. It was so low budget. And if it weren't for Sean Ashmore, the whole cast is just this group of D-list has-beens, or never were. Ugh, God. Like, and yet still there are people on YouTube, you know, recommending it as like, oh, it was actually pretty good. No, it sucked. Oh my God. It was released in 2010, directed by John Knuts. Knuts, whoever the fuck that is. Yeah. It was average at best. I even think giving it a 5.8 is giving it too much credit. But anyway, I guess you could do a lot worse, but you could also do a lot better. That's just my opinion. I would not recommend it. I felt like it was a waste of time. Anyway, again, it was called The Shrine. Okay, take it easy.